Hi folks, today we are going to build a PM2.5 monitor on this Chipsee 5-inch device. I introduced this device in another video. In general, it has an industrial-grade CPU that can run a modern operating system. The CPU speed is on par with a Raspberry Pi and supports many peripherals. In this video, we will use Python, ReactJS, and SDS011 sensor to build this DIY PM2.5 monitor. Let's meet our leading actors first. On the left is the PM2.5 sensor. It is a TTL level serial port. We will be using a TTL to USB converter to connect to our device's USB port. The converter is a CP2102 chip. Although our device has RS232 and RS485 serial ports, they have different levels from the TTL, not the same thing, so they cannot be used together. And I also have this converter, it's a CH340 chip. I have tested the pre-built Debian OS, has proper driver for CP2102, but not CH340. So we will not use this green CH340 converter, but we will be using this red CP2102 chip converter. When we plug in the converter to a USB port, we should be able to see this device in the operating system with IRS USB. We will also need to know what TTY node it is in our OS, so we can use it later in our Python program. In our case, it is /dev/TTY USB0. In our 5-inch device, I have installed Python, Node.js, and NPM. Let's see how we can use Python to read PM2.5 value from the sensor. We will use Flask as a server to talk to our React page later. We will also need a PySDS011 package made by E1 to get data from our sensor. Now let's write our program. First, we import our Flask server, then we initialize the sensor object. Remember our path to the device, we will need it here. We will wake up the device first and use query mode. Then we write a home page route. It will return a JSON of two values, 1 PM 2.5, 1 PM 10. It's only 20 lines of code and should be pretty straightforward. That's pretty much it, but listen here. Did you hear that fun when the program starts? The service life of the sensor is 8,000 hours, so we should put it to sleep when the program finishes and whenever possible. So we add a @exit decorator. It will tell the sensor to go to sleep mode and stop the fun when the program exits. Let's start our web server and test our program. Let's see URL, the root page of our server. See, that's our PM2.5 and PM10 results. They change as the sensor reads another data. Now we create a new React application with NPM and white. Let's first go to our device and see how it looks like. So this is the Debian desktop of our 5-inch device. Let's start a Firefox web browser and visit the React page. Adjust the web page to match our screen resolution, which is 1280x720. So this is how our React page looks like out of box. Next, let's change the React web page. Let's change the count on the button to PM2.5 and give the default state an/a and remove the onclick handler and display PM2.5 on the button. Now count at 0 has changed to PM2.5 is not a number. But it's too small, let's change the CSS to make the text bigger. Now it's bigger, but I think it's still small relative to the screen, and now it's big. Let's remove some unused code and keep it cleaner. The next thing is to fetch our sensor PM2.5 API from React. We will write a use effect hook, set the PM2.5 value, then we get a result from Flask JSON response on component mount. But when we do this, the browser will complain about a CORS error, so we'll need to modify one line in our Flask server to allow CORS in the headers. So now when we refresh the page, we will see our PM2.5 value appear on the screen of our 5-inch device, and when we refresh it again, the value could be fetched again. It's been a long trip. The prototype is almost done. You can take a cup of coffee now and enjoy the moment. Then let's complete the rest of the project.
So how can we automatically fetch the data and refresh every few seconds? We can set an interval to let React do this and update part of the page, say for every 3000 milliseconds. And don't forget to clear the interval when the component unmounts. Cool, now our PM2.5 monitor is requesting real-time data from our Python server. Let's see it in real. This is how our monitor looks like in real life, and the 5-inch device on the left is fetching data from the sensor on the right. Let me set the browser to full screen to make it look better. You can also write a script to start this in kiosk full screen mode. After a bit styling, you can make the interface look better, like a logo, some animation, and also you can hide the mouse to give it a more native feeling. And let's do something dangerous. If you are below 18 years old, please don't do this unless you are with your parents. I lit a candle and let the smoke flow into the sensor. Watch the PM2.5 value ramping up. It can go really high with more smoke. Okay, the value will fall down faster with a waving cap.
Cool, that's our lab for today. We built a PM2.5 monitor with Python, React, and SDS011 on our Chipsee 5-inch device. You can run this program on your own PC. I have put the source code on GitHub. If you would like to see more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe. I'm Gao Fang, thanks for watching.